Welcome back to another video, everybody. Thanks for tuning in. It's been a little while since the last one. That's not because I've been lazing around doing nothing. It's all been pretty busy. So things have been moving on a little bit, but I've just not taken the time to pull together an update video until now. The workshop is coming on. I've managed to reclaim the whole of my garage back now. So my car is out of it. The extension is up. So I'll put some pictures in now, round about now, just to show how that's looking. So yeah, the walls are up, the roof is on. I've put the lighting in, and I have my air line running all the way through to the front garage now, which is where the car's going to be living now. So the Triumph is in there under a cover. The garage door is on quite a long lead time, so I've got something like another 7 or 8 weeks before that garage door is available. So, and the garage is just, it's about 12 inches shorter, or the extension on the garage is about 12 inches shorter than the overall length of the car. The car's a 1973 Triumph 2000. It's got an auto box and a full length sunroof, and it's really, I've had it since 2012, but it's been tucked away in the garage for the last few years. It hasn't seen the light of day for a while, so that's coming out this summer, and there's been various reasons why that hasn't come out, just a few things that I won't bore you with. So the reason that's under a cover, well, it'll be under a cover anyway, but it's poking out at the front of the garage at the moment, because I can't take the original doors off until I get the new front door on the garage. There's a pedestrian door waiting to go on, and then on the original garage, I'll be having a new window and a new door, just to make it a bit more secure. I finally pulled my finger out and did something on the lathe drawers. So I'll just take a few minutes now just to explain what I've done, what my approach was, and perhaps a little bit around what the next steps are. So I'm just gonna cut here for a minute. I'm gonna drop the tripod down, and then hopefully that'll give a slightly better view of what I'm gonna show you next. So in terms of the lathe drawers, these took me, well, probably about a week to make in total, a bit less than a week. So I fabricated these drawers using my little sheet metal worker from my Clark metal worker, which I bought from Machine Mart. It's nearly all made out of 0.9mm Zintec sheets. Zintec is a zinc plated mild steel sheet. And the reason I went for that material was that if you use galvanized steel, then you have to, if you're going to paint it, which I probably will do at some stage, I haven't painted the drawer boxes yet, because I was just figuring out the design, and I was just figuring out if I liked the way I've configured them before I went to the length of painting them. But anyway, Zintec, it's just a bit more convenient to paint than galv. You can just put primer straight onto Zintec and it'll take it straight, that's fine. In terms of the sequence of making these drawers, I made the top one first, the bottom one second, and the middle one last. Not for any reason, that's just the way I did it. And as I went, I kind of improved the design. I probably should have designed them properly in the first place, but I just kind of thought I'd see how they'd go. They were quite experimental, because I've been finding out what size sheets I can work on my little press brake, and so anyway, that's why it's a little bit like that. So the top drawer, this is made out of five main pieces. This top drawer. So the two sides are individual pieces, the back and the front are individual pieces, and then there's a bottom to the box, which is another individual piece. and that's all riveted together. It would have been a lot neater if I had a spot welder, and I was very tempted to buy a spot welder, but anyway, I managed to withstand the temptation. And then there's a drawer front here, which is made from a bit heavier steel, and this was already painted. So I used that, cut that carefully so I didn't flake the edges. And then I made these little handles out of stainless steel. So these have, let me move it around a bit. So these have a safe edge here. So this is, has like a 180 degree bend here. And then that's rolled nice and flat. And then I've put roughly 45 degree bend there, and then a 90 there. So that forms quite a nice little handle. It's about the right size. I tried to model it on the handle of my roller cabinet. It's about the right size, I think. In terms of the execution of it, so let me show you what I mean. What I've got here is a few layers of material, so it's a bit gash really, but I'll probably remake this drawer. So anyway, I've got the handle here, I've got the face plate that, or the drawer front, the grey plate that I showed you, and then this is the front face of the drawer box. So if I was making this again, would I put the front plate on the drawer? Probably not. I'd probably just put the face, the drawer front, straight onto the drawer box. And I may still do that, so I may remove this here. Just there's less, it just looks messy, and there's less to catch your fingers on. And what I might do is put this handle over on the inside, so that then when you look at it from the front, and this was kind of part of the design feature, I kind of designed it so that I'd have this stainless steel strip along the top, because in my mind I kind of thought it would look quite nice, and I don't dislike it, but I may just put the handle behind it so it's grey all the way up, and then the handle just disappears over the back, and then there'll be a nice safe clean edge over the top here then, so there won't be a risk of catching my fingers or my hands on any sharp edges. And then inside the drawer itself, so I wanted the top drawer to have all of my tools in, so this makes a very convenient little top drawer to open as I'm working on the machine. If I want to change tool, yes, I could put my tools up on the shelf, but I quite like the idea of having them tucked away. They're not gathering dust. They stay, well, they're as clean as I put them away. So as you can see, these aren't all clear. There's some brass swarf on the parting off tool and what have you. Anyway, that's my intention, and we'll see how it goes. So the liner inside the drawer, this is, there's something like a 2 or 3 millimeter neoprene base layer. And then on top of that, there's a 12 millimeter layer where I've cut out some little pockets here with a scalpel, so that my turning tools just fit in there, because what would happen otherwise is when I open and close the drawer, all these things go flying around, and I really don't want carbide tips bashing into each other or into the back of other tool holders and anything like that. So they're held really securely in here now. They're not going to fall out. So I've got my size A tools along the bottom here. And then I've got my AA tools here. If you've seen my other video, I've got two sets of tool holders. So the size AA goes onto my compound slide. The size A goes onto my solid tool post. And I've bored you to death on that video already. So I won't repeat myself here about that. There's just a few little bits in this drawer that I need to finish off. So these little box spanners for locking off these screws and the lock nut on here. I need to make a little cutout for those, and chuck key for the drill chuck for the tailstock, and then cabinet key, and then a smaller box spanner for the size AA tool holder. I don't want to fill this up too much, but it kind of forces me to only have the things that I'm meant to have in here. And then there's hopefully some good organisation that will help keep the thing tidy. So I'll skip to the bottom one. So this was a little bit different. This is all made out of Zintec. So the sides are made from Zintec. The side panels are separate pieces, but the base and the front and the back are all one piece. So there's a fold down the bottom there. And these were easy to make because they weren't all one piece. But you know, there's still these, you can see the rivet heads poking through here, which exist on the top drawer, but you can't see it because I've got a layer of neoprene on there. So I'm yet to put a neoprene layer in here. Same again, I'll have some cutouts so that my chucks fit into them. The chuck jaws will have a little pocket to rest in. And then there'll be a little space for my ER40 collet chuck in here as well. So everything will be organised. This one here, so this is the last one that I made. And this really would have benefited the most out of being spot welded, because this is probably the best of them all now. So what I've done with this one is, on previous videos I've talked about why I put a double bend on things. So all the other ones have double bends on the sides, but I've put a double bend again on the sides of this one, and it kind of conceals the draw runner from above. Well, you can see it from the side, of course, but from above you don't see it. You wouldn't know it was there. Not that it's an issue. I've made this one. So the draw box is probably the most rigid in this configuration. So it has a double bend side to side. The front piece has a double bend along here. And the back, which you won't be able to see, has a double bend on the back. So it keeps this front edge nice and straight, nice and stiff. But again, I've done the same thing as I did on the front one, where the draw front, this piece of plate here, this lurks up behind the back of the handle. So what I'll do with this is I'll take the handle off, I'll put it in between this front plate and the draw box. So the other thing is, this drawer, I'll have plenty of spare space in this for the time being. So maybe I'll find a home for things like spare inserts and things like that in here. But so again, I'll line this drawer with some neoprene. And so obviously I've got my compound slide in here, so that kind of wobbles around a bit. So if I close that, does that. So what I'll do is I'll just build it up so that this is supported nicely, and this the taper will fit into a little pocket, and then that'll be nice and snug. It won't move around. And then next to it I'll make a space for my solid tool post mount as well. But in terms of general appearance, you know, they probably won't change much, but just a few little finishing touches really to make them look a bit nicer. So that's an overview of the lathe drawer, some of the considerations that I tried to make when I was putting them together, and how I intend to use them. And what I'll do now is I'll just drop a few little clips and pictures now of various stages of making them. I wasn't very good at collecting footage while I was making these parts, because I was figuring out what the best way to make them was, and really what kind of capacity my little press brake was capable of holding in terms of part size. So it was definitely experimental all the way, and shouldn't be thought of as a how-to video in terms of how to fabricate a toolbox or any tool drawers, anything of that nature, but just, you know, my approach and what I've done. If I was going to make these again, I'd probably do a much better job, and I may remake them, who knows. But anyway, I'll drop it in now and hope you enjoy it. Right, so this is the stage that we're up to now. So I've cut the sheet out, as you can see. Here's the surface development of the box. I need to flatten off these corners where the sheet's a bit kinked from where I've trimmed bits with the snips and what have you. I'm just working out now the sequence of all of the bends. So along here, that's an example of one of the flaps which I'm going to use to rivet the box together. And then here, these lines, I don't know if they're coming across on the video, but there's like tram lines here, 10mm wide. So I'm going to do a double bend on here. So on the outside of the drawer, the double bend goes outwards. On the front and back, I'm going to put the bends on the inside, or at least the front one is going to be on the inside. The back one might go on the outside. So that's why I just have to think about the sequence for putting the bends on. Okay, so here's my little metal working machine. So it's got a folding section here on this press brake. It's got rollers on the top, and this is a guillotine here as well. Right, so what we're looking at here, this is effectively the underneath surface of the drawer box. So what we've got is these, we've got the, can you see that? Yeah. So we've got the double bends on here. So on this side and this side, they're all going the same way. This one is going, can you see it? This one's going the other way. So in a minute, I'm going to be folding this sheet along these lines here, and they're all going to be folding downwards away. So I need to transfer the markings over onto the other side, and then what we'll have then is the makings of the box. Segment now, but thanks for watching, the subscriber count is mounting, so thank you to everyone for subscribing, and welcome to the new subscribers. Hope you find something that is of interest to you. the next video is I've got a cup to make for a wheel bearing removal tool for my brother's BMW. So that's next weekend's job. So I'll probably show a little video of that next weekend. So anyway, thanks for watching, and I'll see you soon. Bye for now.